Ladies and gentlemen of the board, school board, Mecklenburg County, it is 6 o'clock, a little after 6 o'clock, and we, I'd like to call together the organization of the school board for 2018. And the roll call.
Mr. Ritchie?
Present.
Mr. Sturdivan?
Present.
Mrs. Bailey?
Present.
Mr. Palmer?
Present.
Mr. Honeycutt?
Present.
Mr. Campbell?
Present.
Mrs. Garner?
Present.
Mr. Johnson?
Present.
Mr. Edwards?
Present.
Thank you. May I have a recommendation for chairman?
Mr. Nichols, I'd like to recommend that Brent Ritchie be our chairman for this coming year.
Is there a second?
Second.
Are there any other nominations?
I'd like to nominate Dale Sturdivan as chairman.
Do we have a second?
Second.
Okay. I'd like to have, do this as a roll call for everybody indicating whom they would choose to vote for, is that correct?
We need to do the first one first.
I'll do the first one first, and then I'll do.
Do the first one?
Yeah.
Yes.
Do the first one.
All right, now, I guess I should ask, are there any more nominations for the position of chairman? Hearing none, I would like for the vote to be called for Mr. Ritchie as chairman.
Mr. Ritchie?
Yes.
Mr. Sturdivan?
No.
Mrs. Bailey?
Yes.
Mr. Palmer?
Yes.
Mr. Honeycutt?
Yes.
Mr. Campbell?
Yes.
Mrs. Garner?
No.
Mr. Johnson?
No.
Mr. Edwards?
No.
That's five yes. Four no.
If that is a majority, do we need to move further on the?
No, majority.
No.
Okay. Mr. Ritchie, I will turn the gavel over to you as chairman. Congratulations.
Thank you. Next on the agenda. Do I have any nominations for vice chair?
Mr. Chairman.
I would like to. Ladies first.
I would like to nominate Dale Sturdivan, please.
Okay. Do I have a second?
Second.
Mr. Chairman, I would like to nominate Wanda Bailey as vice chairman of our board.
Do I have a second?
Second.
Any other nominations? All right, so I guess we'll do a roll call for Wanda Bailey. No, Dale Sturdivan first, sorry, he's first.
Okay. Mr. Sturdivan?
Yes.
Mrs. Bailey?
No.
Mr. Palmer?
No.
Mr. Honeycutt?
No.
Mr. Campbell?
No.
Mrs. Garner?
Yes.
Mr. Johnson?
Yes.
Mr. Edwards?
Yes.
Mr. Ritchie?
No. All right, now we'll need a.
Two, three. It's four yes, five no.
So I imagine we need to do a roll call on the second.
Yes. Mr. Sturdivan?
No.
Mrs. Bailey?
Yes.
Mr. Palmer?
No.
Mr. Honeycutt?
Yes.
Mr. Campbell?
Yes.
Mrs. Garner?
No.
Mr. Johnson?
No.
Mr. Edwards?
No.
Mr. Ritchie?
Yes. Do we have to open up for more nominations?
One, two, three, four, five. I have four yes and five no.
If I'm not mistaken, now we have to wait. for, I mean, I don't think you can, you can't open the floor back up, it's already been closed.
What are you voting for?
He voted no, so she didn't get five votes. Dale didn't get five and she didn't get five.
Yeah.
You voted them both down. We had this happen one time before with the chairman, and we couldn't do it again till the next meeting.
Yeah, we closed for nominations.
Yeah, you closed nominations, so you can't open the floor back now till next meeting.
Can you remind me, what vote was which one?
The first vote was for Mr. Sturdivant, and the second.
And that was what?
Four yes, five no.
Okay.
And the second vote was for Mrs. Bailey, and it was four yes, five no.
So we'll just need to put it on our next agenda?
Okay.
Does that sound right to you?
That's where we had to happen one time before with chairman, and we had to wait till February, elect the chairman. It's been a few years back because he couldn't open the floor back up for nomination, so we kind of.
Right.
I mean.
Is any way we can get a legal clarification on that? Just because I don't know.
I don't think we can get in touch with that school board attorney, but I don't expect it will be in.
I just want some clarification to make sure that we are proceeding like we're supposed to.
It will not stop the meeting from going because we have a chairman.
We can continue.
We can continue as a chairman. We can call for a vote. You could ask for a recount of the nominations that have been opened. And/or you can wait until next month to do another vote. But we can continue the meeting because we do have a chairman, and we can go into the next one of clerk, deputy clerk, and all of that, just to keep the meeting going.
And I believe that next time maybe that an alternative way of voting would be to vote instead of voting up and down on each candidate is to vote for which candidate you want. Isn't that true? I asked that last year.
Last year when this happened, we just recounted. Because the same thing happened last year, as you recall. I would request a recount on both nominees.
Is that what you said, Dale? That something somebody could request as well?
What does the parliamentarian say?
We don't have one yet.
I guess we don't.
Yeah, we don't have one yet. Because we gotta get the vote.
We have a chair.
No, we have a chair.
I don't know. I just know how it's done one time before. I don't know today what the rules are.
We can call for a revote and/or continue on with the other nominations. So that we're not in a delay. We can go through the rest of it and come back to a recount, or we can ask for the bring that up for next month. Ideally, you want to have all of these people in place tonight.
I think we probably should have a recount tonight then.
That was my sentiment.
And be done with that.
I'm only one board member.
Can we have a roll call again? Is anybody opposed to that? To stay with the two nominees and recount again?
I don't see it makes any difference. We'll do it tonight or next month.
It does make a difference.
But what I'm saying is, sir, let's do it tonight. I'm for that. Don't argue with me. I just want to go and do it.
I'm not arguing, Mr. Edwards, if you'll let me finish my statement. In the brink of new schools and moving forward in a positive manner.
Amen, bro.
I want a recount. I'd like to have a recount.
Anybody else opposed? Nobody's opposed to that?
No.
I don't hear anybody opposed to that. All right, madam.
Okay.
I think we voted on Mr. Sturdivant first.
Yes. Okay, this is for Mr. Sturdivant. Mr. Sturdivant?
Yes.
Mrs. Bailey?
No.
Mr. Palmer?
No.
Mr. Honeycutt?
No.
Mr. Campbell?
No.
Mrs. Garner?
Yes.
Mr. Johnson?
Yes.
Mr. Edwards?
Yes.
Mr. Ritchie?
No.
Okay, it's the same as before. For Mrs. Bailey? Mr. Sturdivant?
No.
Mrs. Bailey?
Yes.
Mr. Palmer?
Yes.
Mr. Honeycutt?
Yes.
Mr. Campbell?
Yes.
Mrs. Garner?
No.
Mr. Johnson?
No.
Mr. Edwards?
No.
Mr. Ritchie?
Yes.
Okay. This time it is 5 yes, 4 no.
Okay. Now we are to clerk.
I'd like to make a motion that we keep Paula Giamatti on as school board clerk.
Second.
Are there any other nominations for school board clerk?
Does she accept it first?
Sure.
Okay. Good point. All right, I have a recommendation and a second that Paula Giamatti be appointed as clerk of the school board. Roll call.
Mr. Sturdivant?
Yes.
Mrs. Bailey?
Yes.
Mr. Palmer?
Yes.
Mr. Honeycutt?
Yes.
Mr. Campbell?
Yes.
Mrs. Garner?
Yes.
Mr. Johnson?
Yes.
Mr. Edwards?
Yes.
Mr. Ritchie?
Yes. Deputy clerk. Currently, Sharon Shuttleworth is the deputy clerk. Do I have any nominations for that position?
I make a motion that we keep the deputy clerk the same. Mrs. Shuttleworth, if she will accept.
Okay.
Sir?
She's using the gauge.
Oh, okay.
I second. Okay, we got a motion from Mr. Honeycutt, second by Mr. Campbell for Ms. Shuttleworth to be the deputy clerk. Are there any more nominations?
Okay.
So we have none. Let's have a roll call.
Mr. Sturdivant?
Yes.
Mrs. Bailey?
Yes.
Mr. Palmer?
Yes.
Mr. Honeycutt?
Yes.
Mr. Campbell?
Yes.
Mrs. Garner?
Yes.
Mr. Johnson?
Yes.
Mr. Edwards?
Yes.
Mr. Ritchie?
Yes. Code of conduct. This is the school board adopts the code of conduct for school board clerks. This is the code of conduct for clerks. Is that the one published by the VSBA? Do I have a motion that the school board adopts the code of conduct for school board clerks?
So moved.
Second.
I have a motion by Mr. Honeycutt, seconded by Mr. Sturdivant. Roll call, please.
Mr. Sturdivant?
Yes.
Mrs. Bailey?
Yes.
Mr. Palmer?
Yes.
Mr. Honeycutt?
Yes.
Mr. Campbell?
Yes.
Mrs. Garner?
Yes.
Mr. Johnson?
Yes.
Mr. Edwards?
Yes.
Mr. Ritchie?
Yes. Parliamentarian.
Make a motion that Gavin Honeycutt be appointed school board parliamentarian.
Second.
Any more nominations? Gavin, are you?
I will.
Yes. All right, no more nominations?
Mr. Sturdivant?
Yes.
Mrs. Bailey?
Yes.
Mr. Palmer?
Yes.
Mr. Honeycutt?
Yes.
Mr. Campbell?
Yes.
Mrs. Garner?
Yes.
Mr. Johnson?
Yes.
Mr. Edwards?
Yes.
Mr. Ritchie?
Yes. Superintendent's designee. We have a recommendation that Dr. Christy Somerville Midget and Mrs. Joan Height be appointed as designees to sign for official correspondence for the superintendent in the superintendent's absence.
So moved.
Second.
Motion by Mr. Honeycutt, seconded by Mr. Sturdivant. Roll call, please.
Mr. Sturdivant?
Yes.
Mrs. Bailey?
Yes.
Mr. Palmer?
Yes.
Mr. Honeycutt?
Yes.
Mr. Campbell?
Yes.
Mrs. Garner?
Yes.
Mr. Johnson?
Yes.
Mr. Edwards?
Yes.
Mr. Ritchie?
Yes. Superintendent's designee for meeting attendance. Do I have a recommendation that Dr. Christy Somerville Midget be appointed as the designee of the division superintendent to attend meetings in the absence or inability of the superintendent to attend?
So moved.
Second. I have a motion by Mr. Edwards, seconded by Mr. Palmer. Roll call, please.
Mr. Sturdivant?
Yes.
Mrs. Bailey?
Yes.
Mr. Palmer?
Yes.
Mr. Honeycutt?
Yes.
Mr. Campbell?
Yes.
Mrs. Garner?
Yes.
Mr. Johnson?
Yes.
Mr. Edwards?
Yes.
Mr. Ritchie?
Yes. Governor's Schools, school delegate. Okay, what's that?
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to nominate Dora Garner to continue in that role.
I'll second.
Okay, I have one nominee. Does anybody else have a nomination? No, it was Dora Garner was nominated by Mr. Edwards, seconded by Mr. Palmer. Roll call, please.
Mr. Sturdivan?
Yes.
Mrs. Bailey?
Yes.
Mr. Palmer?
Yes.
Mr. Honeycutt?
Yes.
Mr. Campbell?
I have one question. Are you still going to be able to go to the meetings?
Yes.
Okay, yes.
Mrs. Garner?
Yes.
Mr. Johnson?
Yes.
Mr. Edwards?
Yes.
Mr. Ritchie?
Yes. Governor's School Alternative, or Alternate.
Make a motion that Mr. Palmer serves as alternate on the Regional School Joint Board of Control.
Second.
Any other nominations? All right, I have a nomination for Mr. Palmer by Mr. Sturdivan and seconded by Mr. Honeycutt. Roll call, please.
Mr. Sturdivan?
Yes.
Mrs. Bailey?
Yes.
Mr. Palmer?
Yes.
Mr. Honeycutt?
Yes.
Mr. Campbell?
Yes.
Mrs. Garner?
Yes.
Mr. Johnson?
Yes.
Mr. Edwards?
Yes.
Mr. Ritchie?
Yes. And I have a motion that meeting dates and times shall be established as the third Monday of each month, unless otherwise noted, with closed meetings beginning at 6 and open public meetings beginning at 7. Meetings will be held at the school board office in Boyd.
So, can I?
Sure.
At one time, we were discussing having the open meeting, then have the closed meeting, then coming out and vote, so that the people wouldn't have to sit here forever. Is that still something we were thinking about? Or am I losing my mind?
I know the Board of Supervisors does it that way, and it's, I guess it's the will of the board.
Now, repeat that.
You would have the regular meeting at 6. And then you go into closed session, do whatever you got to do in closed session, and then come out and just vote.
And do all your voting afterwards, or just the action of the personnel?
Just the action after, just like Board Supervisor.
Okay.
I mean, it's just, I think, more convenient for the public.
It does hold
some
the public.
Of our closed sessions take an hour and 20 minutes,
right.
And they're sitting here waiting.
But they want to hear the vote, they got to sit and wait anyway. That don't take.
Well, yeah, but if they want to hear the vote. But, I mean, you've seen our audience. As soon as we do recognitions, it's the people that are required to be here.
Right.
All right, do you think people will have trouble getting here by 6?
I don't know. I mean, that was just something that I remember we discussed at one time, or I thought we had, and I was just asking if that was decided or not. That's the only reason.
It's not decided. It's something we can talk about.
Yeah. Does anybody else have any comments on our schedule?
I think it would be hard for the public.
There was a reason it was changed years ago, even before I came on the board, and they used to do that. And what happened was, if you had like a teachers or students or something, they would sit around and wait and wait and wait. And sometimes a closed session would last more than an hour. Because that's what happens. If you don't have a time for closed session and have to come out of there by 7 most of the time, you'll find it running on over, and then you get disciplined people. It was changed, and that was before I came on the board, but I don't know.
And that's fine.
Yeah,
I just remembered us talking about it at some point. I just wanted
to make
sure.
That's interesting. Alternative, yeah.
But yeah, that's fine. Okay.
But we had. I guess we can vote on what the motion was on, and then we'll see. So the motion was to the way it is now, the third Monday, unless otherwise noted, closed meeting beginning at 6. The open meeting beginning at 7. And I can't remember, we have a motion and a second on that?
Mr. Honeycutt made the motion.
I made the motion. Mr. Johnson seconded it.
Can I ask a question?
Sure.
Are we going to look at these exceptions again next year for Martin Luther King Day to be on Tuesday? The board meeting be on Tuesday like it is this year?
That's how the calendar reads.
Mm-hmm. This is unless otherwise noted in the motion, so. I think everybody's been okay.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Pretty much all that.
Yeah. All right, any more discussion? All right, roll call, please.
Mr. Sturdivan?
Yes.
Mrs. Bailey?
Yes.
Mr. Palmer?
Yes.
Mr. Honeycutt?
Yes.
Mr. Campbell?
Yes.
Mrs. Garner?
Yes.
Mr. Johnson?
Yes.
Mr. Edwards?
Yes.
Mr. Ritchie?
Yes. Code of conduct for school board members.
I make a motion that we adopt or we put in place the code of conduct outlined by the Virginia School Board Association.
Okay.
As written.
I have a motion by Mr. Honeycutt that we adopt the school, that the school board adopts the VSBA Code of Conduct for school board members, and seconded by Ms. Bailey. Roll call, please.
What question? I see there are places for us to sign. Will we need to sign that?
Yeah, and I believe only the people who vote
for it
sign.
Okay, I just wanted to.
Isn't that the way?
I think we did it that way last year, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, so roll call.
Mr. Sturdivan?
Yes.
Mrs. Bailey?
Yes.
Mr. Palmer?
Yes.
Mr. Honeycutt?
Yes.
Mr. Campbell?
Yes.
Mrs. Garner?
Abstain.
Mr. Johnson?
Yes.
Mr. Edwards?
Abstain.
Mr. Ritchie?
Yes. All right. That ends our organizational meeting, and now we're on to the adoption of tonight's agenda. I have a motion that the school board adopts the agenda.
So moved, Mr. Chairman.
Could I ask a question?
Sure.
Are we voting on the site tonight?
No, sir.
No.
No.
We're not voting on the site. I have on here that we will hopefully take a vote on the RFP to go out, but we cannot vote on the site until the Joint Education Committee affirms that that's the site that they would recommend to the two boards. And we were told at the last committee meeting that until we have information on the price of the land that they have put the option on, and it has been cleared that there are no underground storage tanks or things that are unknown at this point, they can't vote to be able to do that. That's why, as I understand, why it wasn't voted on at the last Joint Education Committee.
Okay. I have another question too.
Sure.
So I see it as an action item on tonight's agenda.
What's that?
G.
G. I'm sorry.
The RFP.
Yes, sir. I'm sorry. The RFP. Do we, at that point, do we make a motion what that RFP is going to say, or we're just putting it out there?
The RFP has already been written by the superintendent. We just vote to authorize the RFP go out.
And I have copies of it here. We sent out copies.
I guess what he's asking is, do we get to review the RFP?
It was on the, you sent email.
A draft copy.
A draft, but I haven't, I just assumed we were going to have time to talk about it.
Well, you can, I think you will have time to do that.
Yeah, we're going to discuss it when it comes up for a motion.
So do you have the same draft copy, or do you have a final copy?
I have a draft, still draft.
Draft, still draft.
Until you all approve it.
Yeah, the RFP is just particulars about what the hiring the architects want to do, and what, if we want to see it, it'd just be on a review level because they write it, and we just support that we want to hire an architect.
And since sending it out, the members of the board have the opportunity, and even then I have the opportunity to ask further questions. That's why I have copies of what, with some questions that have been asked, and with dates, assuming it would be passed tonight, but the dates would be changed if it's not, or you can still change dates on it.
So the RFP goes out for how many days?
It depends on what
it's
doing. Usually it's like 30 days. We make a decision like 30 days, you know, 3 weeks to 30 days, I think is the way we used to do it. And then we'll start interviewing architects and narrow the thing down, and then move forward with hiring one, let them start to work. I don't think location right now, I think that's pretty much over the hump.
Well,
I think the reason this board of supervisors wants us to move forward with an architect is we got to spend $2.5 million in the next 60 to 90 days, because see, we committed for that under the $50 million rule. We had to spend that money.
Right.
So if we hire an architect, then that we can flow that money to the architect, and we'll be off and running. And then some of that money will go towards land purchase too. But if we don't get that land purchase done, and that's a lot of legal stuff has to be done before you can buy land, we got to spend some money. I mean, that's just, we got to do that.
I have copies. I did read over it, but I didn't know if we were sending, I just wanted a clarification what actually, once we vote on it, what's actually going out. Are we going to have time to discuss any of this?
Yes.
Before right. It actually
goes out? Let's also be careful. This is open session.
Right. We have it in our closed session.
So be careful.
We have the option. Yeah, that's right. This discussion in closed session.
Okay.
So just be careful how much we discuss of this.
Well,
the particulars, because we are in open session.
Okay.
But there's an op, when we get to the action items, there is, after the motion has been put forward and seconded, there's time for discussion as well.
Okay.
Yeah, sorry. So we are, yeah, and if we want to talk about any specifics close meeting wise, we can do that in the close meeting. We're back to the adoption of the agenda. Let's see, here we are. Did I have a motion to adopt?
Send the, Mr. Chairman.
Second.
Okay, I have a motion by Ms. Bailey, seconded by Mr. Honeycutt, that we adopt the agenda for tonight. Roll call, please.
Mr. Sturdivan?
Yes.
Mrs. Bailey?
Yes.
Mr. Palmer?
Yes.
Mr. Honeycutt?
Yes.
Mr. Campbell?
Yes.
Mrs. Garner?
Yes.
Mr. Johnson?
Yes.
Mr. Edwards?
Yes.
Mr. Ritchie?
Yes. All right, going into the closed meeting. Do I have a motion that the school board convenes a closed meeting for personnel matters regarding resignations, retirement supplements, adjustments, employment grievances, and discipline pursuant to Code of Virginia Section 2.23711A1, student matters regarding student discipline and tuition reimbursement pursuant to Code of Virginia Section 2.23711A2, matters regarding the acquisition of real property pursuant to Code of Virginia Section 2.23711A3, and legal matters regarding possible litigation pursuant to Code of Virginia Section 2.23711A7.
So moved.
I have a motion by Mr. Honeycutt.
Second.
Seconded by Mr. Palmer. Roll call, please.
Mr. Sturdivan?
Yes.
Mrs. Bailey?
Yes.
Mr. Palmer?
Yes.
Mr. Honeycutt?
Yes.
Mr. Campbell?
Yes.
Mrs. Garner?
Yes.
Mr. Johnson?
Yes.
Mr. Edwards?
Yes.
Mr. Ritchie?
Yes.
Okay.
Close meeting. Get down the hall.
Yes.
Can I have a motion that the closed meeting be closed and that the board certifies that to the best of each member's knowledge, only the public business matters lawfully exempted from the open meeting to which this certification applies, and only such business matters as were identified in the motion concerning the closed meeting were heard, discussed, or considered.
So moved.
Second. I have a motion by Mr. Honeycutt, seconded by Mr. Edwards. Roll call, please.
Mr. Sturdivan?
Yes.
Mrs. Bailey?
Yes.
Mr. Palmer?
Yes.
Mr. Honeycutt?
Yes.
Mr. Campbell?
Yes.
Mrs. Garner?
Yes.
Mr. Johnson?
Yes.
Mr. Edwards?
Yes.
Mr. Ritchie?
Yes. Now, would you please join me with the Pledge of Allegiance and a moment of silence?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Mrs. Hyde, you have some recognitions for us.
Yes, sir. Good evening, Mr. Chairman, Mr. Nichols, school board members. Tonight we have two seniors that we would like to recognize. I'm going to start with Bluestone High School Senior of the Month, and I would like to invite to the podium Takia Amaya Hicks. Takia? Takia is the daughter of Miss Marquita Hicks, and she resides in Chase City, Virginia. She attends Saloon Baptist Church in Chase City. She's a member of the Usher Board. Takia is a trustworthy and reliable young lady. Her friends always enjoy being around her because of her mannerisms. She is sincere in her kind words and exemplifies an excellent attitude. Miss Kimberly Ritchie, her British literature teacher, states, Takia is a confident, intelligent, and polite young lady who is a joy to teach. As a teacher, I can depend on her to be prepared for each and every class and complete the work with a level of proficiency that many other students cannot. Takiyah is also very helpful to her classmates and being a willing participant to answer questions in class when others would rather not. Her personality makes spending time with her a complete joy. Her political science teacher, Ms. Catherine Jackson, reiterated Ms. Ritchie's views of Takiyah's capabilities. Ms. Jackson also added, I have taught Takiyah Hicks for 3 years. When it comes to her education, Takiyah doesn't accept average. When given an assignment, she is able to look ahead and envision the end result and works diligently to achieve the best. Takiyah's smile is contagious, and she plays the flute for the band, and she's a member of the Beta Club. Math is her favorite subject, and after high school, she wants to attend a four-year university and major in criminal justice. She's very interested in attending VCU. And Bluestone High School is very proud to have her as the senior of the month. Okay. Mr. Ritchie, at this time, I would like to recognize now Parkview High School senior of the month, and this is Zachary Curry. Zachary? Parkview High School would like you to meet Zachary Curry, and he is the January senior of the month. He is the son of John and Susan Curry of Bracy. He's involved in cross country. He also does indoor and outdoor track. He's part of the FBLA, the Beta Club, and PTK, and I had to ask what that was because I did not know, and it's the Phi Theta Kappa, so I didn't recognize the initials when I first saw it. Outside of school, Zach is a volunteer at the Bread Box, and he is a member of Rehoboth Methodist Church, and he is very active in their Vacation Bible School program each summer. Mr. Bursch is his math DE teacher, and he says, Zach exemplifies the positive qualities that we hope and desire for our students. He is always focused and on task, demonstrating a deep desire to not only learn the material, but to master even the most complex concepts. He's always willing to help his fellow students to understand the material and be successful. His demeanor in the classroom is pleasant, courteous, positive, and helpful. Zach exhibits qualities such as honesty, integrity, and compassion. Mr. George Thompson, his former history teacher, says that Zach's citizenship and behavior qualities are the top of the scale also. He presents himself with a peaceful demeanor and a gentle smile. To watch his interaction with his peers, the teacher, it's as though his confidence carries him through the day, but he still remains very humble. In his free time, Zach enjoys running, working out, art, photography, and visiting Walt Disney World. He has been recognized for his stellar academia by being inducted into the Honor Society, which I previously mentioned, and for having all A's. He was also awarded the Leadership Award for track last year, and after graduation, he wants to attend college, and he would like to major in cybersecurity. And Parkview is very proud to have him as the senior of the month.
Good evening, Mr. Chairman, Mr. Nichols, board member. It is my pleasure tonight to recognize our Mecklenburg County Division Spelling Bee winner. On last Thursday evening, we held the Division Spelling Bee here at Central Office. We had representatives from each elementary school and middle school. And tonight, I want to recognize Nicholas Sweet, fifth grade student at Chase City Elementary, as our Division Spelling Bee winner. He is accompanied tonight by his parents, Dan and Alicia Sweet. He was thankful for all the extra days over Christmas and the snow break to study his spelling words, and it looks like he might have one or two more coming this week, so he will be ready. He will now go to the Library of Virginia in Richmond on Saturday, March the 10th, where he will participate in the regional spelling bee. So we want to wish him the best of luck on behalf of Mecklenburg County.
Yep. So he's in fifth grade, but he competed against sixth through eighth graders as
yes,
well.
Yes, he did.
Here. Very
yes,
good.
He did. And won.
Impressive. Sure. We'll just take a minute to congratulate the Students of the Month and the Spelling Bee winner before you sit down.
They would come back up.
If you don't mind, just take us a minute.
Thank you, Mr. Richmond. Members of the board, tonight we do not have as large an agenda as we typically do for information, I'm thankful to say. But there are a few things that we want to bring to your attention, the first of which is it's time again for students to begin signing up for next year's classes. And in your package you have a copy of the student handbook that has been put together for this year. Again, we may have some comments from Ms. Height about the handbook and will be available to answer questions that you might have. The main thing I think you need to realize is that it is a work of progress. It is continuing to be developed as we have class opportunities and the teachers that are appropriate. So you will continue to see information come up about classes and opportunities for our students for next year. And sometimes at the last minute, things get changed because of our partnerships with community colleges and others. But we are working to make them the classes as strong as we can. I changed my introductory letter at both the middle and high school level in a way that is hopefully carrying the message that school is the job for these students. And we're looking to help them be prepared as they look at their careers. So, Ms. Height, did you have anything that you wanted to add? Or? Any questions that anyone has as we look that over?
Yes, Mr. Nichols.
Yes, sir.
Next year, are the kids from each high school going to be commuting back and forth to the other high schools for classes?
That's
go ahead. We are not in a position to offer all of the classes that we currently have. The ROTC, the automotive mechanics, and others are simply not available on both campuses. And so, if a student is interested, right now it's an offer. I know that there's been some concerns about discipline and things and traveling back and forth, and this board has the option to select and say that's not going to be available.
But currently it's offered.
But currently it is offered as we make it available on both ends. There are other transportation opportunities that will come along. We have students going to government school. We have students going to the Advanced Knowledge Center in South Hill. We have students going, if we have the cosmetology next year, they'll be going to Jay City, to the Estes Center. And it's possible that we'll have some students even available to go to the Higher Ed Center for some options. So transportation is a reality.
So at what point will we make a decision on whether or not kids from Bluestone will be going to Parkview for automotive? What would be the cutoff so that the kids and parents will know?
That will be up to you. If you have a recommendation that they would not, that would not be an option, we need to know.
So you're recommending that it is.
We cannot offer.
Right, I understand that. We have robotics at Bluestone, and we have to. Do we transport Parkview students?
Robotics is a
in wrestling.
Robotics and
that's after school.
Yeah, that's fine. Activities. They're not classes.
Okay.
But Teals is a class, and we do have students going from Parkview to Bluestone to be participating in the Teals class.
To make do.
Yes.
Mr. Chairman.
Yes, sir. I think I know what Mr. Servant is talking about, and moving forward with on the brink of building new buildings, secondary buildings for our school, we need to engage every opportunity on a secondary level for all of our students. Moving from today, until we get these new schools built. We need to give our each child in this county an opportunity to do whatever he or she wants to do. You know, moving forward with these new schools, I know, you know, it might be an issue here or there, but collaboratively, I believe all of us can work together and come up with the best solution so none of our children lose in the county.
We are very aware of time requirements for these classes for students to be able to complete the programs that they're a part of. And anytime there's transportation on a bus, it eats into some of the time that's there. That's always a problem. And so we are being very much more focused on the issue of making sure that transportation is done in such a way that it's early enough or late enough that students don't miss any more time from the classroom part as necessary. And I'm sure Mr. Cyphers would be the best one to address questions about that.
And I bring that up because we're having an issue with required time.
Right.
And if we know we're having a problem with required time, then do we continue sending the kids to each school where they're missing out or not meeting the minimum requirements? That's my question.
Mr. Cyphers, do you want to address that? Because we've got a federal audit coming up, and that's one of the things that's going to be considered in the federal audit.
Good evening, Mr. Ritchie, school board members, Mr. Nichols. We're looking at several different options. I talked to one of the guidance folks today as far as how we're going to address the issue. We do need to look at some things as far as the audit that's coming up with our NATEF recertification that will come up in October is when it's due. We do need to look at those issues and determine how we're going to proceed and make sure we have those, how we're going to make that time up documented, because if for some reason we were not granted to continue to run the program, it wouldn't be that it would just be for Bluestone, it would be for the entire school division. So we looked at some things today at possibly looking at one of the options was if we could do automotive one, which is generally one semester for one block, look at possibly double blocking that and mixing it together with and the automotive two and the three doing the same thing and mix some of those classes together, because generally they're a smaller group of students. So we're trying to come up with a way that we can still meet the hours, but also not impact the number of students that could actually enroll in the program. Because when we go into double blocking automotive one, we either do it for a full year that impacts the number of students that we have that can take the program, it'll actually cut down on some of the other numbers. So we're trying to look at some ways on how to solve the time issue.
Two things that I would add to that. One is that sometimes we may need to actually let the students know if they're going to choose to take the class, they will need to arrive at school earlier like governor school students do, be transported to the place that they would take a class and to spend the amount of time that's necessary in the day. That would be, we have a requirement for governor school. We may need to look at something of that nature as we look at some of these career technical programs. The other thing, and this will bring us to the conversation about the Career Tech Academy that you have before you, the Go Virginia program and the focus of the state has been on making sure that within each of the Go Virginia regions, there are sufficient numbers of students, even starting in the K-12 environment, to be able to meet the numbers of workers in areas. And these mechatronics, precision machining, work-ready foundations, and IT Academy are four centers that are high dollar in training that we cannot necessarily set aside the IT Academy, afford the equipment to be able to start these programs. And so we're looking at a partnership with Halifax County, Charlotte County, Higher Education Center, Community College, both Davil Community College and Southside Virginia Community College, to offer these classes with the funding for the equipment going into the higher ed center. The funding for the equipment, which is well over $1 million, has been put into the governor's budget because the governor, this meets the expectation of what the governor is looking for economic development in the state with partnerships that would be a part of the Go Virginia program. There is also a grant from Go Virginia that was applied for by the partnership of the schools with the higher ed center, and that grant is in consideration at this point. And this would be a program that would have sufficient number of hours required. Would probably mean that we would need, as we were talking about, to have some students leave a bit early, as they do to go to the governor's school to meet those hours. But there's an innovation component that we are looking at. The innovation component, which would be very important to us for the future opportunities that are coming along, is that we will be identifying within the CTE programs themselves the math, science, and some of the English requirements for graduation. And we will be able to identify those and have a blended classroom set up where students would be given credit for the math that they're doing there. So it's much more practical, and it meets the expectations for graduation, and it gives them the time to do the CTE program as opposed to having to come back so early to meet the graduation requirements. So there are numbers of great opportunities that the Department of Education is excited to work with us on as we develop this. And I bring it to you as we talk about this, because this center could be available to some of our students as early as next year. The precision machining will not. It will take another year for that equipment to be ordered to come in, but the cost of it has been put in the governor's budget, and we're looking for it to be to pass through the General Assembly, because it is a economic development issue for this region of the state. And again, I think it's exciting because it could put us in a position as being identified by the state, which was a requirement out of last year's General Assembly, for schools to have the opportunity to be identified as divisions of innovation. And this gives us the option for a division of innovation to participate in this program. And that fits exactly what we're talking about, the number of hours that are required. Other questions? There's no need for action on this. It's an ongoing program, but we're starting the scheduling. The counselors are working with them, the students, this week and next week, I think, at Parkview. Yes, and we'll soon be at Bluestone. And then part of it needs to be in place for the federal audit, which is coming up in February.
Yes, sir.
So, Mr. Seifus, let me get this straight. If they do not have the needed hours, it affects both ends, both schools?
If that, when they do the audit, they determine that that's an area that needs to be addressed, or if they determine that's an area that would prevent us from having a program.
Okay.
But, of course, it would be up to NATEF when they come in and audit it. We're actually going to the NATEF audit, and we went through when I first got here, we went through the preliminary piece of the audit, and then this is the full audit. And that's DOE requires that you have NATEF certification to offer the automotive program.
Other question?
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
As we're talking about the career centers, I would just like to I'm very pleased to bring to the attention of the board that I was asked last night to give a presentation to the NAACP's annual Martin Luther King dinner. And I think it went very well, but the important thing to bring to your attention is they have made a commitment to help sponsor the Career Center concept that we're working with. And they gave a donation of $300 last night as the first down payment on that. They will be having a annual golf tournament, and they said that they would consider each year looking at the proceeds of the golf tournament being able to support our schools in that way. So I brought that back to our schools today, and we're looking forward to being able to use that for many, many good purposes with our career centers. I also want to bring up that, of course, the state legislature is now in session. There are over 300 bills related to education this year. Some of the very same ones that we've seen in the past related to school suspensions, related to when schools may open, related to students and many of the concerns that people have about restraint for students and discipline for students, related to financial issues supporting schools,
related to the teacher shortage are all there, and we will be working on a weekly basis, have a weekly call in with the persons at the Virginia Vets, the Virginia Association of School Superintendents, to try to keep up with these, and we'll be updating you as we have opportunity. The other thing that I want to bring to your attention tonight is that we had, in coming back to school this year after our break, we had some significant weather issues. I don't need to remind anybody about the weather issues, but we did have, particularly at Parkview Middle School, some significant issues with the heating systems. And the sixth grade annex, basically, that was supplied by the hot water from the boilers that were old. The systems themselves, not the systems, but the pump going out to the annex and the pipes. The pump failed, the pipes froze. Some of the heating units inside of the classrooms also froze during that time. It was something that was being continuously monitored by maintenance because we've been watching the boilers and the other things that have been in place. And yet that particular pump is not something that you can watch, and the freeze was so hard that we've had to come back. I alerted you by email as we had to do these, but I did go last week to the Board of Supervisors, and they agreed to appropriate emergency funds to be able to try to fix that. The principal and teachers worked with Ms. Height on a modified schedule for sixth grade students to be able to go into the main building, and they are currently doing that. We are in the process of, we have checked on the possibility of fixing the plumbing for the heating systems, and they are not repairable. And so we have now come back and are actually installing some heat pump options in the classrooms, and hope within, Brian, 2 weeks. How long do we? 1 week.
Weather permitting, probably next week.
Hopefully next week that the sixth grade wing will be available for the students to go back into. It is a constant battle. As you know, this board and I inherited, and the administration inherited buildings that have had some significant maintenance issues, and we are working on it on all of them on a daily basis. But we're thankful the Board of Supervisors appropriated the funding, and we're going to, I don't think we're going to use all of it that they appropriated, because we want to be good stewards with the money, but we want to make sure that the students have the appropriate heat that is necessary during this time. And hopefully, we have closed school for tomorrow because of where the forecast is that we're going to get some significant snow tonight. The weather forecast also says that we will not have a break in temperatures rising above freezing until Thursday. We have to deal with the amount of time that we have banked for snow days, and some decisions will have to be made on those issues, because I know nobody wants to come back during Easter break, but we have that. But we will be continuing to work with you and letting you know, and I will try to make the calls as soon as I can. I will say last Tuesday morning was a devil of a time for the weather, and we again did the best we could with the decision today. And if anybody has any questions about that, I'll be happy to answer.
Good job.
Okay. Thank you. And Mr. Chairman, that's all of my informational items and reports for tonight.
One thing I wanted to say is it was a year ago this month that we had to cancel, and I remember well, cancel the basketball season for Parkview Senior High School because of their behavior at a Brunswick tournament. And just recently, a week ago, they played Brunswick, at Brunswick. You know, I'd like to commend our people. When we played Brunswick at Parkview, I thought that our administration and everybody did a great job, and it went off without a hitch. There was a little bit of trouble at Brunswick, but our guys really, I admire the way that they behave themselves, because they're young men, and I understand there's a lot of emotion in that, and they behave themselves very well, and I appreciate the job that Coach Watkins is doing this year, and the athletic committee, Mr. Sturtevant and Mr. Palmer, and spending time making sure, really, to get the best coach that they could. That was important because we were switching coaches, and I wanted them to put their, I really wanted that team to put their best foot forward so we could put that incident behind us. And I really believe that they did. I think Coach Watkins has done a great job, and the young men have done a great job. So I appreciate everybody that put the work into that to make this season really a turnaround. And we can really put that ugliness behind us. So thank you to my two board members here in the athletic committee for the work y'all put in with that. I think you spent a lot of time thinking about that. Now we're on the committee reports. Joint Education Capital Improvement Committee. Anything to report?
I think everybody read it in the newspaper. You know, I think we've narrowed down site selection, and we're moving forward. I look forward to having a new school sooner than later.
Can I ask you a couple questions?
Yes, sir.
Who picked the sites for those to be studied?
I've
been reading the social media, and I just think some clarification needs to be made.
They were brought to the committee by the county. The county had researched and through the engineer actually looked at different sites from
so nobody on the school board?
Nobody on the school board had anything to do with the site selection. It was actually done by the engineering firm, and they came in with recommendations, and then we narrowed it down. It went from like 3 to 6. I mean, the whole area has been searched in depth. And so there's a lot of things that enter into it. It's amazing how many things enter into picking a site and narrowing it down. It's been a long process, and I think it's narrowed down to the point now we can maybe move forward and get some things done. You know, we got to have a school. But no, the school board didn't pick the site.
And no school board, no member of the school board had any influence on which sites were picked?
I don't think so. No, I actually think it was, it's been a lot of talk, a lot of feelings get hurt, and people say things that they wish they hadn't said. And,
yes,
but,
they did.
But we're at the point now that we need to move forward and build a school and get
it. I just want to make sure the public knows where their money went, why it went where it went, without all the speculation.
When we finally bring it out, I think everything will be fine. We will build a school.
All right. The Finance Committee?
Yes, Mr. Chairman, the Finance Committee met today at 5 o'clock. We reviewed the bills. We will have a recommendation when that time comes. Mr. Nichols also gave us some updates, some round numbers about our budget request. And we continue to work on that. This may be the year that it takes a little extra time in Richmond to finalize those numbers, but we're hoping that they will be favorable. He did mention that our composite index has risen 2 points, which means that our locality will have to increase. Typically, that's what that means. The locality has to pick up the difference. But given all that, we are still optimistic, and we have a good plan for the request, especially personnel request. The next meeting of the Finance Committee will be in February. That will also be a budget work session meeting. Superintendent will be presenting his budget at that time. So we will move our meeting time to 4 o'clock that afternoon. So if you'd like an up close and personal look at the superintendent's budget, please plan to attend at 4 o'clock at our February meeting. That's it.
And if I'm right, that 2% doesn't sound like a lot, but I believe that's about close to $1 million, isn't it, in our budget?
It's a significant amount of money.
Yes. Yeah, so
it moved from roughly 0.34 to roughly 0.36.
Right.
That's something the state determines, not the locality. And it is Mecklenburg County's composite index numbers are the highest in Southern Virginia by far.
So they really just shifted another $1 million of responsibility onto the county. Okay, Gifted, Talented, Special Ed, Health, and Family Committee.
Yes, there's a meeting February 13th at 4 o'clock for the Gifted Advisory Committee. Also, the board members and some of the people in Mecklenburg County, especially on this end that go to governance school at SVCC in Keysville, they lost one of the governance school students this year, this month, or this week, I think. So it was tragic to hear that from Laura Michelson, and everybody here had already been told. But if you have a student that's going to governance school, you probably have already heard it too. So.
And she was from Amelia County High School,
yes.
Right? Okay, the CT career technical, anything additional, Mr. Cyphers?
Good evening again, Mr. Chairman, school board members, and Mr. Nichols. In celebration of CTE Month, which is February, I just wanted to remind you all and invite you all out, as well as the public and anyone else that would like to attend. You have a flyer for our CTE Expos. We will have February 7th is at Bluestone High School. This will consist of both Bluestone Middle and Bluestone High School students in our CTE program. And on February the 8th, we'll have our CTE Expo on the Parkview side with both of our Parkview Middle and Parkview High School students. And both of them will be held at the school library. So if you all can attend, we'd love to have you all come out and see all the great things our students and teachers are doing.
When is that now?
February the 7th
okay.
is Bluestone's Expo, and February the 8th is Parkview's. Both of them are from 4:15 to 6:30. Both of them are in the high school libraries, and it falls in conjunction with the parent-teacher conference night as well. And again, both middle schools will be participating with each of their respective high schools this year.
Thank you.
Thank you.
The athletic
athletics are going well. You mentioned earlier basketball. Basketball season is going well for both teams, as well as indoor track. We have students still applying to get on the indoor track teams. I spoke with Mike Green today. He said the invitation is still open for other kids at Parkview High School that want to run the indoor track. I believe the activity buses are going to be here this month. And hopefully when they get here, they can be used for athletics and any other student activities in the school system. That's all I have.
Thank you. The instruction committee? I don't believe we have anything new.
The last time we met was the last meeting. So we have.
Okay, thank you. Now we're to our public input section of the meeting. Madam Clerk, is there anyone signed up to speak?
Yes. At this time, matters may be publicly brought to the attention of the board and administration. Public comment at school board meetings are just one of the many avenues for communication, and the board recognizes and appreciates the importance of input from and communication with the public we represent. The public is invited to sign up to speak. The clerk of the school board will write down your name, contact information, and the topic that you wish to speak about. The public is allowed up to 6 minutes at most meetings to express their views. Please respect that time limitation. It will be enforced. Please understand that it may not be possible to immediately respond to questions. As a reminder, it is inappropriate at a public meeting to make personal attacks, to be defamatory, or to disparage individuals or identifiable groups. Again, we welcome and appreciate your input. Prior to beginning your comment, please state your name to the board. Angela Brooks.
Hi, I'm Angela Brooks, but you already touched on the subject I was going to ask you about, Mr. Nichols. I was concerned in regards to the heat. I did make a social media attack today, and I apologize for offending anybody, Mr. Ritchie, you included. That was not my case at all. I was just trying to get some answers. I have been in this community, as you well all know. You have known me since I was 15 because he was my counselor at Brunswick High School. But I have lived here since I was 15. I have children in the school system, one who is 11 and in the sixth grade, which, as you know, is not working. I also have a high schooler who's a senior, and guess what? She has no heat either in a lot of her classes. And this has been something that has been going on since 2002, when my eldest child attended Parkview Middle School, as well as my eldest daughter, who also went to Parkview Middle School. And so I think I've been very patient for the last 16 years to see it get fixed, and I do hope it does get fixed, at least in order for us to get to our new schools. That was my main concern. I think 44 degrees inside of a classroom is entirely too cold for any student or any staff member or teacher to have to endure. And that's all I'd like to say.
Thank you.
That's everyone.
We have reached the action portion of our meeting. First item, the minutes from the regular school board meeting held December 18th, 2017. Can I have a recommendation that the school board, or can I have a motion that the school board approves the minutes of the regular school board meeting held on December 18th, 2017?
So moved.
Second. I have a motion from Mr. Honeycutt, seconded by Mr. Palmer. Roll call, please.
Mr. Sturdivant?
Yes.
Mrs. Bailey?
Yes.
Mr. Palmer?
Yes.
Mr. Honeycutt?
Yes.
Mr. Campbell?
Yes.
Mrs. Garner?
Yes.
Mr. Johnson?
Yes.
Mr. Edwards?
Yes.
Mr. Ritchie?
Yes. May I have a motion that the school board approves the payments of the bills?
The Finance Committee recommends that the bills be paid as presented, Mr. Chairman.
Okay, we have a recommendation from the Finance Committee. May I have a roll call, please?
Mr. Sturdivant?
Yes.
Mrs. Bailey?
Yes.
Mr. Palmer?
Yes.
Mr. Honeycutt?
Yes.
Mr. Campbell?
Yes.
Mrs. Garner?
Yes.
Mr. Johnson?
Yes.
Mr. Edwards?
Yes.
Mr. Ritchie?
Yes. May I have a recommendation, or excuse me, may I have a motion that the school board approves the personnel recommendations?
So moved.
Second.
I have a motion from Mr. Honeycutt, seconded by Ms. Bailey. Roll call, please.
Mr. Sturdivant?
Yes.
Mrs. Bailey?
Yes.
Mr. Palmer?
Yes.
Mr. Honeycutt?
Yes.
Mr. Campbell?
Yes.
Mrs. Garner?
Yes.
Mr. Johnson?
Yes.
Mr. Edwards?
Yes.
Mr. Ritchie?
Yes. May I have a motion that the school board approves the superintendent's recommendation regarding student matter SD 2017-2018-11?
So moved.
And that's the student discipline, correct?
That's the student discipline.
I second.
I have a motion from Mr. Edwards, seconded by Ms. Garner. Any discussion? No discussion. Roll call, please.
Mr. Sturdivant?
No.
Mrs. Bailey?
Yes.
Mr. Palmer?
No.
Mr. Honeycutt?
Yes.
Mr. Campbell?
Yes.
Mrs. Garner?
Yes.
Mr. Johnson?
No.
Mr. Edwards?
Yes.
Mr. Ritchie?
Yes. Can we have a tally on that one?
Sure. I have 6 yes, 3 no.
May I have a motion that the school board approves the superintendent's recommendation regarding student matter SM 2017-2018-12?
So moved.
Second.
I have a motion from Ms. Garner, seconded by Mr. Sturdivant. Roll call, please.
Mr. Sturdivant?
Yes.
Mrs. Bailey?
No.
Mr. Palmer?
Yes.
Mr. Honeycutt?
Yes.
Mr. Campbell?
Yes.
Mrs. Garner?
Yes.
Mr. Johnson?
Yes.
Mr. Edwards?
Yes.
Mr. Ritchie?
Yes. May I have a motion that the school board approves option... Which option are we?
Option 1.
Well, this is a blank.
Yes, option 1.
May I have a motion that the school board approves option 1 of the 2018-2019 school calendar?
So moved.
Do we have an answer to the question?
We can get discussion after we get a second.
Yeah, after you get a second.
Okay.
Got a motion for Ms. Bailey. Do I have a second?
Second.
Second, yeah. Any discussion?
I do have one question. Maybe Mrs. Height or Mrs. Rogers can answer this. How many instructional hours are built into that schedule?
Calculations that if we were to cut our instructional day by 10 minutes, then we would minutes add up. And part of our situation with our calendar is we have the 4x4, so we are held to completing a semester. The hope is to complete that semester before Christmas. So everything evolves around that Christmas break, and then we work backwards. And that is why we are where we are. There are 140 clock hours for a class, so I know we exceed that. However, it's partly due to high school requirements and mandates from the state.
Thank you.
What's the start date for teachers and start date for students on that calendar?
August 3rd.
I'm sorry, say again.
I want to know what the start date for the teachers and what is the start date for the students on that particular calendar.
Actually, can we get both?
Option one, the start date for new teachers, they come back on August 1st. They have 3 days of new teacher orientation. And then all staff reports on the 6th of August, which is convocation. And students come to school, their first day is on the 13th, that's a Monday.
And that's option one? That's what's recommended?
That's the recommendation. There were 327 total votes in the division, with 221 voting for option one.
And those are the teachers, right? So the teachers are?
With the staff.
The staff.
The school staff.
They make the recommendation to us.
They are the ones that provide the input. The calendar is created by the staff from all the schools. All the schools are represented. And we work with the parameters that we have, and these are the two proposals. The only changes, again, that I recommended or brought to your attention last month is that in option one, they have the half days, and they don't start as early. So when we start in July with new teachers, that really puts a crunch on the calendar. The second semester does not change at all.
Ms. Albert, just by chance, do you have the dates of the other option?
I have option two, that was when new teachers returned on the 1st, and then all teachers returned for convocation on the 2nd, and the first day of school was the 9th.
So the first option, which we're voting on, the students will start later.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you.
And that's the option that the staff wanted.
That's the option.
So we're just supporting their recommendation.
Based on the votes that were turned in to each of the representatives from the schools, I asked them to put it out to their schools so that they could get feedback, and they turned in the votes to me.
And
I have those votes.
I think there was some concern about just whichever option we had, getting the students to come in at the latest date, and I think that's the option that you're recommending.
That's correct. Yes.
Thank you.
You're welcome. One other note on the calendar for that option, we do have those half days. The dismissal time should be 12 rather than 1. And then I had a suggestion that we change that return date for the second semester to note that it is the beginning of the second semester for the purposes of eligibility for athletics. So I'll make that change as well if that's okay with the board.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Thank you.
Is there any more discussion? All right, I have a motion and a second. Did you write? I didn't get that. I don't remember who did that. Did you get that?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Did
I just need a roll call?
Mr. Sturdivant?
Yes.
Mrs. Bailey?
Yes.
Mr. Palmer?
Yes.
Mr. Honeycutt?
Yes.
Mr. Campbell?
Yes.
Mrs. Garner?
Yes.
Mr. Johnson?
Yes.
Mr. Edwards?
Yes.
Mr. Ritchie?
Yes. All right, may I have a motion that the school board supports the request for proposals, RFP for architects?
I'd like to make the motion that we support the RFP to be sent out for an architect on the site that we've
Can't tell we're anxious to do this, can
you? Yeah.
I have a motion.
It's like we have an option to buy.
All right, I have a motion. Do I have a second?
Second.
I don't think you can stipulate the site in the motion.
I don't think you didn't say anything about that.
I said on the site we got the option.
Yeah.
Can't do that because we can't do that.
This is just for the RFP.
This is
for
the RFP.
We have to wait for the recommendation to do anything on the site. Okay. So go ahead and say that again.
Make a motion that we send out the RFP to Optech.
Second. And I got a second from Mr. Palmer, a motion from Mr. Campbell. Any discussion?
Yes. I was just saying I'm excited.
Yeah, we all are. We were just, this is happening. I know sometimes it may seem slow, but we're being, it's a big project, it's a lot of money, we're being careful. Due diligence. So, any more discussion? All right, Madam Clerk, roll call, please.
Mr. Sturdivant?
Yes.
Mrs. Bailey?
Yes.
Mr. Palmer?
Yes.
Mr. Honeycutt?
Yes.
Mr. Campbell?
Yes.
Mrs. Garner?
Yes.
Mr. Johnson?
Yes.
Mr. Edwards?
Yes.
Mr. Ritchie?
Yes. All right, reminders. As Mr. Cyphers told us, we had the CT Expos, which those are well worth attending. I enjoy those. On the 7th, it's February, we have the one at Bluestone from 4:15 to 6:30. That's the high school. And on the 8th, at Parkview Senior High School from 4:15 to 6:30. And then on the 19th, we have our regular school board meeting. Board member remarks. Why don't I start over here on my right tonight? Ms. Garner, do you have any?
I like to say that we have to keep the Williamson family in our prayers. They lost their home last night. And I know that the school community and many members of the Clarksville community has reached out to help them. So our prayers are with them.
Thank you. Mr. Sturdivant?
Yes. I'd like to say congratulations to Mr. Ritchie and Ms. Bailey, as well as Mr. Honeycutt and Ms. Dora Garner for their appointments for this year. We're closer than we've ever been with this architect and with our school site. So hopefully, as Mr. Nichols said last night at the NAACP meeting, within 6 months, hopefully we can have some shovels at the site we've chosen and get this process going even faster. That's all I have. Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Johnson?
I have nothing like it.
Thank you. Ms. Bailey?
Yes. I just wanted to let my fellow board members know that I'll be attending the NSBA Advocacy Conference the first weekend in February. I will be going with a delegation of other Virginia school board members from Virginia. We will be meeting with Senators Kane and Senators Warner on the evening of February the 5th. I also have an appointment with Congressman Garrett the morning of February 6th. One of the school board members from Brunswick County will be going with us also, and we'll be talking with Representative Garrett together. If there's something that you would like for me to carry there, please let me know via email or give me a phone call and let me know if there's something you'd like me to convey. But mainly we will be talking about rural education and the plight of funding in a rural education setting with federal guidelines and state guidelines and how we get that done. Also, we'll be advocating for the Carl Perkins monies that we traditionally get, that those monies would not be cut, and so thank you for that opportunity. And then if you want to win a spelling bee, and if Mr. Sweet were here to share, I bet he's an avid reader, because avid readers make great spellers. So if you want to win a spelling bee, read more books. Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Edwards.
I'd like to thank our maintenance department. I'm in the construction business, and I know what these guys went through day and night trying to get this heat on and digging holes and finding leaks underground that had frozen. And it was cold out there for these guys, and they worked hard, and they came up with ideas and begged for funding to get us back on our feet. And I know it disrupts the kids and the families, but with these age schools, they're doing everything they possibly can. We've got a great crew, probably the best we've had in years, because I've been here for years, and it's probably the best maintenance program we've had in years. So I just want to thank them for their hard work.
Here, here.
Mr. Palmer.
Yes, I want to pretty much echo what I've just heard. I had the opportunity of going by Podview Middle Saturday morning, and people were out there. The gentlemen that are working on the heat system were out there working Saturday morning, as cold as it was. I knew a couple of the guys, and I stopped there and had conversation with them. They are really dedicated to getting our schools back up wherein that our students will be comfortable. The other thing is that I want everyone to know how happy I am that we have pretty much got to a point where we can see the end of the, at the end of the tunnel, so to speak, and it's not the train coming. We see our school getting ready to be built, and we need that because all of our buildings now are really in bad shape. I have to be honest about it, and we need these new schools.
Thank you. Mr. Campbell. Did you want to?
I don't know.
Okay, well, this is my turn.
Forgive me, I wrote mine down. Good evening, and thank you, Mr. Chairman, for giving me the opportunity to speak during board member remarks. The past 2 years have come and gone very quickly for me as a school board member. I ran for office because I wanted to be a voice for our children, our faculty, and administrators of Mecklenburg County Public Schools. I will say that this process has been at times physically and emotionally exhausting. It has not been an easy road to get where we are today. I am very excited, though, that we are moving forward and on the brink of building new secondary schools for Mecklenburg County. But again, I will emphasize that this process has not been easy. I can only speak for myself and not any other board member sitting on this board. With this being said, if we're going to move forward in a positive manner as a school board, we must put aside any and all words or actions that cause division in our schools. We should no longer throw any other board member under the bus, whether it be newspaper or social media or the computer. We should have respect for one another. I know that we're not always going to agree on everything, but it's okay to agree to disagree. The latest social media post on Facebook was about another board member accusing another board member of fraternization with landowners for a site for our new school. This is slander in every shape, form, and fashion. To the public, they could misconceive this as favoritism or somehow someone is gaining something financially. The public is sick and tired of the back and forth. We are here to work for the children, faculty, and staff of this school division. End of story. We can no longer blame, or should we blame, any other previous boards for our shortcomings. We can no longer blame these people. This was in the past. If we continue to have this disruption by school board members going forward, I encourage the public to call these people out and voice their opinion. This is 2018, and a fresh start and a new beginning for Mecklenburg County Public Schools, as well as myself. This board as a whole should want this in moving forward. I attended the NAACP banquet last night in South Hill. I was inspired by the unity in the room and the sense of everyone wanting to move forward. This should be the same for our school division. I have a dream of walking through a new set of doors in a couple of years and seeing the endless possibilities that we as a school division can achieve if we work together for the same goal, not our own agendas. My hope is that everyone in the state will look to Mecklenburg County Schools as a source of positive strength, giving all of our children the same opportunities to learn and achieve goals beyond their dreams. Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Campbell?
Yeah, Gavin kind of stole a bunch of my thunder there. But I want y'all to know that tonight was the first night that we've had a unanimous vote on a school since we started. I don't know if y'all realize that or not. The very first night we've had a unanimous vote. Everybody talks about East and West, East and West. Well, we can't expect our communities to get past East and West if we don't. I don't think there's a board member here that wants the East and West to fight anymore. Is that that fair to say? With that being said, when we talk, we should be talking as one voice. It shouldn't be the ones on the east or the ones on the west, because we can't expect this community to come together unless we do. And for that being said, Ms. Gardner, get your facts straight before you post on social media. And if you continue to not do that, for goodness sake, spell my name correctly. And with that being said, I make a motion we adjourn.
Let me take my turn here real quick.
Oh, sorry. You already had your turn.
I just wanted to, like what Mr. Edwards said about our maintenance department, and I know that we had somebody speak about the heat, and she did not offend me speaking about the heat. I just said I have kids in the middle school as well, and you know it has its shortcomings, but my kids, they love their school. They love their teachers, the administration, and they love their school. And I just my point to what I said was that I just support our maintenance director, our superintendent, as doing everything they can do to get things fixed and have things suitable for our kids. And I trust them with two of my own. So, all right, that being said, do I have a motion to adjourn?
I make a motion to adjourn.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.